Also, we have the Arabic program to support the Islamic studies. So students will balance, will have this balanced character that we are looking for. Balance between deen and dunya. So the child will grow up knowing their religion, and also they will have the grades, the marks, to be able to go to the university, to the department of their choice. I'm asking everybody here to support this school by spreading the word. If you are interested in registering your child or children, our team is waiting out there, outside the mosque, after the prayer. We have information for you. We have brochures. So we give you more information, contact information. Please, if you don't have children, you can spread the word to your nephews, to your nieces, to your neighbors, to your friends. And the school is a private school, so there's fees. However, the fees would be waived for the Syrians for the first year, and for those who need help, assistance. Jazakumullahu khairan, wassalamu alaikum.
Just a couple quick announcements, inshallah. So we have the next week, or next Saturday, I should say, so August 26th, inshallah, is the end of summer barbecue at Hordlake Park from 5 to 9. This information is also available on our Facebook page. Also, on the September the 10th, inshallah, is the Eid Fair. So it is a kind of an event across the city. It's actually led by an Ansari Youth Association, as well as various masajid in town. So again, this is Eid Fair, it's an all-day event at the Butter Dome on September the 10th, inshallah. And then also, finally, we have the Arabic classes that are starting for those for adults, Arabic classes for adults who are interested, inshallah. That's provided through our Dawah committee, and that's going to start on September. The information is also available on our Facebook page as well. So again, that's Arabi for adults who are interested in learning Arabi. That's available on our Facebook page, and that's gonna start in September as well. So please make sure you register for that. Jazakumullah khair.
Assalamu alaikum. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتدى ومن يضل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أرسله الله تبارك وتعالى رحمةً للعالمين إمامًا للمتقين وحجةً علينا نحن الخلائق أجمعين فأخرجنا به من ظلمات الكفر إلى نور الإيمان بالله رب العالمين فاللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إخوة الإسلام كان من المفترض أن نستكمل حديثنا عن مقاصد الشريعة حديثنا الذي بدأناه منذ أسابيع وما زلنا معه ولكن لا ينبغي أن تمر هذه الأيام الفضيلة أفضل أيام السنة دون أن نقف أمامها حتى وإن كنا نذكر بذلك كل عام فهذا هو المقصد وهذا هو الهدف من هذا المنبر منبر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم So my dear brothers and listening sisters as you might be expecting that we will be continuing talking about the objectives of the Sharia as we still have like maybe a couple of khutbahs about this particular topic that we started a few weeks ago but I need to put it on hold this week and the coming week inshallah ta'ala for something that to highlight the importance of this season of ibadah. You cannot live in that time without understanding that the virtue of that time, of these days. In few days, you and I will be receiving, we will be welcoming the best 10 days of the whole year. I'm talking about a special season. And by the way, if I'm putting maqasid al-shari'ah, the objectives of the shari'ah on hold, I'm still will be connecting that to my topic today. Because we said the first objective of the shari'ah is that it's for you to protect your religion for you. And look how Islam gives you chance after chance to protect your religion. To strengthen your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. هكذا يدير الإسلام وتدير الشريعة الإسلامية حياتك. كل ما عليك أن تنظر إلى هذه النعم وهذه النفحات نظرة أو نظرة تمعن وأن تقبلها ليس إلا. ولذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الصحيح يقول افعل الخير دهرك حينما تتحدث عن ووقتا آخر بغير عبادة كما يعني يفعل البعض بعض الناس. وأنتم تعرفونني جيدا، أنا أبدا لا ألوم أحد على أي شيء، ولست في مقام ألوم فيه أحدا على شيء. إن كنت لائما فألوم نفسي أولا، ولكن بعض الناس يصلي الجمعة وبعد ذلك يتذكر الجمعة أو الجمعة الثانية أن عليه صلاة وبين الجمعتين لم يصلي. وبعض الناس يصوم في رمضان ويزكي في رمضان ويتصدق في رمضان ويصلي في رمضان، وما أن ينقطع رمضان لا تجده. هذا ما لم أبدا تريده الشريعة الإسلامية منا. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول افعل الخير نهركم، كل شيء عليك أن تقوم به، ومع ذلك إن كانت هناك لمحة اقبلها لا ترفضها، إن كانت هناك أيام فضيلة تعرض لها، قف أمامها استفد منها خير الاستفادة. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم افعلوا الخير دهركم وتعرضوا لنفحات ربكم فإن لربكم في أيام دهركم لنفحات يصيب بها من يشاء. هنا here is the core of this khutbah. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the authentic hadith, you should do the good deeds, the righteous deeds, all of your time, every single day, every single time of your life. However, when you have a season that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses for you, the last 10 days of Ramadan, Laylatul Qadr, the 6 days after Ramadan, the day of Arafah, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, and so on, the time, the last third of the night, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam يقول, however, you have to do all of this, do ibadah all the time, but when you have this time, stop and give it special care. Deal with it differently. There is no hypocrisy here. ليس هناك نفاق. وإنما الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أخي اختار لك ذلك. ألم يختارك أنت على باقي خلقه؟ لما لم يعني تفكر فيها بهذا الإطار؟ الله تبارك وتعالى يقول ولقد كرمنا بني آدم وحملناهم في البر والبحر ورزقناهم من الطيبات وفضلناهم على كثير ممن خلقنا تفضيلا. There is no hypocrisy. It's the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives preference to some of His creature over others. He gives preference to you over all other creatures. And we read that ayah a couple of weeks ago, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preferred you over all of His creatures. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أيضا فضل بعض الأماكن على بعض. تصلي في هذا المسجد ثواب عظيم، ولكن أن تصلي في المسجد الحرام 100,000 صلاة، أن تصلي في المسجد النبوي 1,000 صلاة، أن تصلي في المسجد الأقصى 500 صلاة. من فضل ذلك؟ من أعطى لهذا المكان التفضيل؟ رب العالمين سبحانه وتعالى. إذا أقف أمام ذلك وأقول يا أخي يعني أنا أروح هناك عشان بس أنا منافق؟ لا، لست منافقا. أنت تقبل نعمة ونفحة وهدية رب العالمين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give preference to places. You know what? You pray here? Great. But when you go pray in Al-Masjid Al-Haram, it's 1,000 times of your prayer over here. When you go to Al-Masjid Al-Nabawi, 1,000 times of your prayer over here. When you go to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, 500 times over more than what you pray over here. That's the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same applies to the times. نفس الأمر ينطبق على الأوقات الفضيلة. The same applies to certain times that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses for you. I said earlier, and we covered this, Ramadan is a special day, a special month for you. Take advantage of it. Don't let Ramadan go without adding more and more of the good deeds. And then Ramadan is over. And look at the Sharia here to protect. If I ask you today, Wallahi, I'm not picking on anybody. But today, for me personally, to check the calendar, the Hijri date, I had to go online. That's why if I ask anybody today, what's the day and what's the Hijri month? Yeah, in Hijri month, everybody is like calculating his vacation on the Eid, so maybe you know it's Dhul Qa'dah. But what is the day exactly? It's going to be a problem. And here is the Sharia to protect your religion. You're far. You went far. I know you're not the same person who was in Ramadan. Here is a gift. You want to take it or you want to leave it? Here is a great gift to you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, في الحديث الصحيح الذي رواه سيدنا عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما وأورده الإمام البخاري في صحيحه يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم ركز معي هو ده إيه الخطبة هنخلص بسرعة. I got some requests before the khutbah that I need to finish before 2:20. So some people will be happy today. So النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول في حديث سيدنا عبد الله بن عباس ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيهن أحب إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى منها في هذه العشر. قالوا ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله؟ قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله فلم يرجع بشيء. Again, this Wednesday, most likely Wednesday, the start of the first 10 days of the month of the Hijjah. Again, the best 10 days of the whole year. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and even before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul, وَالْفَجْرْ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. Some of the mufassirun, they refer to the 10 nights to be that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath with the first 10 days of the Hijjah. Okay? And then the Prophet ﷺ comes to you and tells you, you know what? Here is a gift for you. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is no days in the whole year. The righteous deeds are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than these 10 days. That first 10 days of the Hijjah. Count from Wednesday till Thursday, till Friday, the day of Eid, inshaAllah ta'ala. قالوا. Then he said, Ya Rasulullah, you're talking about any act of worship. He said, righteous deeds. He didn't say salah, he didn't say hajj, he didn't say siyam, he didn't say zakah, he didn't say sadaqah, he didn't specify a certain act of worship. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, any righteous deeds you do for the sake of Allah. Then he said, Ya Rasulullah, but we know that somebody who sacrifices himself for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is somebody has the greatest reward ever. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even though this person has a great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing the righteous deeds within these days is better, is more beloved in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than jihad for the sake of Allah, except in one case. And it's hard. This case is not feasible. It's not something that you can do. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله فلم يرجع بشيء. Except in one case, somebody who went out for jihad, taking with him all of his wealth, and he comes back with nothing, meaning that he got murdered for the sake of Allah, and he spent all of his money for the sake of Allah. So you're here to get the same reward of that person if you pay attention to the first 10 days of the month of the Hijjah. Great days, the best days of the year. هذا اليهودي يأتي إلى سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب يقول يا عمر إن في كتابكم لآية لو نزلت علينا نحن اليهود لاتخذنا ذلك اليوم عيدا. طبعا هم كذابين ولا عيد ولا لطيف. لاتخذنا ذلك اليوم عيدا. قال عمر بن الخطاب وهو امير المؤمنين قال ما هذه الآية؟ قال الرجل قوله تعالى اليوم اكملت لكم دينكم واتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الاسلام دين. فقال عمر بن الخطاب للرجل والله انا لنعلم متى نزل واين نزلت على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في عشيه يوم عرفه يوم الجمعه عشيه يوم عرفه وهو huwa yakhtubu fina sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look, yani, if you're not taking too many virtues and bounties and ni'mah in these 10 days, look at the revelation of the last few words of the whole Quran. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking to all of us, telling us that on that day, I have perfected your religion for you, or completed your religion for you, perfected my bounty upon you, and choose that religion, Islam, to be your religion. This man came to Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab and said, Ya Umar, there is an ayah, referring to this ayah. There is an ayah in your Quran, if it was revealed upon us, the Yahud, the Jewish people, we would have taken that day as a day of Eid. We would have celebrated that day. That's the day in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed and perfected His ni'mah upon us. Then Sayyidina Umar told him, which ayah? Then you read the ayah. You read the ayah for him. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum, at the end of Surah At-Tawbah. Then Sayyidina Umar told him, by Allah, we know exactly when and where it was revealed. It was revealed on the day of Friday, the day of Arafah, at the end of the day, on the Prophet وسلم, when he was lecturing, when he was giving us, as you guys know, the farewell khutbah of the Prophet Idan, 10 days has great virtue and ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has the day of Arafah, it has the day of Nahr, it has the day of Eid, it has lots of blessings. What should I do? ماذا علي أن أفعل في هذه الأيام؟ كلها بالمناسبة حتى نقف وقفة واضحة مع الحديث أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يحدد أي شيء، ولكنها كلها اجتهادات. ربما تكون شخصية مني قد أصيب وقد أخطئ، ولكن الأمر يرجع إليك أنت، تحدد ما تفعل. يعني ربما ما أخرجت زكاتك في رمضان تخرجها الآن، ربما يعني مبلغ من المال للصدقة، ربما صلاة أكثر، ربما قراءة قرآن، ربما يعني تبسم في وجه أخيك المسلم أو غير المسلم، ربما دعوة إلى الله تبارك وتعالى. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يحدد. So what should I do? I cannot give you a specific list at the end of the day. It's just my homework that I did to give, يعني it's just quick instruction, but it's up to you, because the Prophet said, anything you do for the sake of Allah on these days will be better than the same thing being done outside the 10 days. Anything, read Quran, give sadaqah, give your zakah out if you miss your zakah in Ramadan. Just be smile to the people, you know, make da'wah, read Quran, whatever you want to do. However, there are things that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stresses in his ahadith that you should do in these days. I'm going to start with the most important thing, and it's going to be my topic for next week, inshallah ta'ala too. The most important thing that has to be done within these days. يعني كثير من الناس أول حاجة تفكر فيها دائما في العشر أيام هي مش كيف أو ما تكلفة الحج هذا العام. كل الناس بتتكلم عن التكلفة. ما حد بيتكلم عن الأجر. ما حد بيتكلم عن المغزى. ما حد بيتكلم عن ماذا سيحصل لي إن ذهبت إلى الحج. كل يقول لك 13, 15, 16, ما أنت معاك فلوس. يعني ما أنت بتدفع للرحلة، ما أنت رحت هاواي كم مرة، رحت أمريكا، رحت يوروب، رحت الميدل إيست، رحت العالم كله، وصرفت كتير جدا من الأموال على هذه الرحلات. هتيجي عند الحاج وتقول لي والله ده بقى اكسبنسيف، ولمن استطاع أي سبيلة، والله أنت مستطيع بس أنت يعني بتضحك على نفسك. So number one thing that you need to think about is make a hajj. I know it's too late. It's too late to arrange for today or this year. But what's your plan for the hajj in your life? This is the fifth pillar of Islam. This is, as the Prophet ﷺ said in the authentic hadith, يعني حديث واضح. سيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه إمام البخاري يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم، ركز معايا، الحج المبرور ليس له ثواب أو جزاء إلا الجنة. What I'm trying to say when I talk about Hajj, and I'm going to be covering that in details next week, inshallah ta'ala, is when you think about planning for Hajj, plan for the reward, not for the expenses. Because every time you and I, we think, you know, it's too much, man. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it's only for those who can make it. But you can, I'm telling you. You just bought a nice car. You're still thinking about buying a house. You put a down payment for whatever. You did this, and you did this, and you did this. And Islam is telling you to perfect your religion. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي. You need to do hajj as long as you can do it physically and financially. Think about it. What I'm going to get? I'm going to give you one hadith only. Next week we'll go talk in details. The Prophet ﷺ says that the accepted hajj has no reward except Jannah. If you and I think about hajj from this perspective, I believe that the whole masjid will be planning for hajj today. Because you're talking about Jannah. You're not talking about a nice car, a nice building, a nice job, a good wife, a good life, whatever it is. You're not talking about that. You're thinking about Jannah beyond the whole world, the whole dunya. You're thinking behind the picture that you see. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from you. Number one thing you need to plan to do, if you cannot do it today or this year, at least inshallah ta'ala from the next year, that's your plan. Al-Umrah. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حينما تحدث عن العمرة قال العمرة إلى العمرة كفارة لما بينهما. يعني when you do عمرة, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told you again in the authentic hadith, by the way it's the same hadith that I get quote about the Hajj, the same thing. العمرة إلى العمرة كفارة لما بينهما between, يعني أنت you went for عمرة, I know, but it's 5 years ago. These 5 years, يعني only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows how much you added to your bad deeds. And the Prophet is telling you, between the Umrah and Umrah and the next Umrah is expiation for all of your sins. And this is a good time to go for Hajj and Umrah together. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يقول أيضا تابعوا حديث في سنن الإمام في سنن الإمام أحمد في مسلم الإمام أحمد يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم تابعوا بين الحج والعمرة. فإذا المتابعة بين الحج والعمرة يعني تنفي الذنوب ويعني وكما تنفي النار خبث الحديد. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم telling you again, go follow up between حج العمرة, make it your habit. It's an ibadah, but something that you care about. يعني you talk to some people now, you know what they thinking? والله some people when they thought about عمرة and they talk to me about it and you tell them, you know what, how much it might cost? I said, really? I thought it's like way more than this. Mawa, he never asked. He never thought about it. And when you even think about it, as I said, about the reward, even the finance, it's not going to be a problem. As long as you do that plan for yourself, Hajj and Umrah, and take advantage of these days. Number two, الأمر الثاني من الأمور التي يجب عليه أو يعني يعني لا يجب ولكن من الأمور التي ينبغي أو يتعين مراعتها في هذه الأيام الفضيلة هو أمر الصوم. ذلك الله تبارك وتعالى يعني تجد أن الصوم دائما وأبدا معنا. رمضان 6 أيام, 10 أيام من الحجة, يوم عرفة, يوم عاشوراء, يوم الاثنين والخميس, 3 أيام البيض. هكذا الصيام دائما وأبدا معنا, لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم روى عن رب العزة سبحانه وتعالى قوله كل عمل ابن آدم له إلا الصوم فإنه لي وأنا أجزي به. If you're talking about one of the great act of worship ever, you're talking about صيام. You're talking about performing صيام as much as you can. That's why Islam, to protect your religion for you, is, you know, prescribing. Let's put it this way, prescribing صيام for you. يخي for the شباب, for example, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول يا معشر الشباب من استطاع منكم الباءة فليتزوج. يعني all you of this ummah, if you're able financially and physically to get married, hasten to get married. ومن لم يستطع فعليه بالصوم. يعني if you cannot get married financially or you're busy with the study whatever, فعليه بالصوم فإنه له وجاء. Let's practice fasting. Let's fast. Prescription from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنَّهُ لَهُ جَاءَ. That's the main protection for you from committing وَالْعَيَنُ بِاللَّهِ إِنِ فَاحِشْ. That's why one of the things that you should do in these days is to practice siyam as much as you can. You can fast 9 days, you can fast like Monday and Thursday, but never ever miss the day of Arafah. اولا الامام ابو داود في سننه روى عن بعض ازواج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم انها قالت ان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يصوم التسع. So this is authentic hadith, by the way. يعني some people came to us before and said that يعني we cannot prescribe that for the people. It's up to them. At the end of the day, it's up to you. But I'm telling you now that it's authentic hadith reported or recorded on the authority of Abu Dawud in his Sunan, on the authority of one of the wives of the Prophet ﷺ, that she said that the Prophet ﷺ used to fast the 9 days of the Hajj. Used to fast the 9 days of the Hajj. You can fast the day in 5. You cannot pick few days. You cannot fast like more than 1 day, never ever miss the day of Arafah. If you're gonna miss everything, never ever miss the day of Arafah. لا يعني تتغافل أبدا عن صيام يوم عرفة. يقول عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم صيامي أو صيام يوم عرفة يكفر السنة الماضية والسنة المستقبلة. You're talking about 2 years. The previous year and the coming year are being expiated for you. The sins are committed committed within these 2 years are expiated for you by fasting 1 day, the day of Arafah. And then number one, go and make as much as you can of Hajj, inshallah, tabarakat ala al-umrah, and then think and plan for fasting starting from this Wednesday. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأدعو الله تبارك وتعالى وأنتم مؤمنين. الحمد لله وكفى صلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وبعد. الله تبارك وتعالى يقول ويذكر الله في أيام معلومات. أحد أهم العبادات أحيانا إما بننحرج أو بنتغافل عنها أو ما نعرفش. أحد أهم العبادات التي تمارس وكان يمارسها صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في هذه الأيام الفضيلة الأيام العشر هي الذكر والتهليل والتكبير قدر الاستطاعة. لذلك قال العلماء ويذكر الله في أيام المعلومات أي في أيام العشر. So one of the things that you and I should do during the 10 days of the Hijjah, the first 10 days of the Hijjah, is to practice dhikr. To remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani speaking of dhikr needs, for sure, different khutbahs, not one khutbah. But the ulama, they said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in specific days. They said that these are the 10 days of the Hijjah. And that was the understanding of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, kama rama al-imamu أحمد في مسنده. يقول قال سيدنا عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من أيام أعظم عند الله من هذه العشر فأكثروا فيها من التهليل والتكبير والتحميد. So سيدنا عبد الله بن عمر said there are no that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said there are no days greater there are no greater days in the sight of Allah سبحانه وتعالى than these days, the first 10 days of the Hijjah. Then to celebrate these days, do 3 things. Akthiru, increase your tahleel, la ilaha illallah. Takbir, Allahu Akbar. Tahmeed, alhamdulillah. Not only as we might think during the day of Eid. Not only after the salah from the day of Arafah until the 3rd day of Tashreeq. It's not only this time. It's with the beginning of the days, the 10 days of the Hijjah. ولذلك Imam Bukhari يروي عن سيدنا عبد الله بن عمر وسيدنا أبو هريرة رضي الله عنهما أنهما كان يخرجان إلى السوق في هذه الأيام الأيام العشر فيكبران ويكبر الناس بتكبيرهما. So Imam Bukhari also reported that both of them, سيدنا عبد الله بن عمر and سيدنا أبو هريرة, they used to go out, make takbir in the streets, in the marketplaces, and then they make takbir and the people make takbir with them. As much as you can. I'm not saying go to workplace and make it takbir, then you're gonna be arrested and then I will be in trouble. I'm not saying that. I'm saying practice takbir. Driving your car, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Nice. It's a good feeling. You're going for like tomorrow's the you know the weekend. You're going out of town, whatever it is, and you're like sitting alone, fishing or doing dhikr. Practice dhikr. That's the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. As I said at the beginning of the khutbah, there are lots to do. Just put it in front of your eyes that anything good deed you do during these days, it will be much better in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than doing the same thing outside the 10 days, starting this Wednesday. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يجعلنا جميعا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا, كفر عنا سيئاتنا, توفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين وأعلي بفضلك كلمة الحق والدين. انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في شتى مشارق الأرض ومغاربها, ثبت على الحق أقدامهم, انصرهم على عدوك وأعدائهم, اغفر يا رب تقصير على تجاههم, وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. صلى الله عليه وسلم على آله وصحبه وسلم.